This bass is actually insane.
Hey, pop the trunk, I open up, I sold my soul a good price out of sight. My whole got talent.
What is up, guys? It's your boy Luminate back here for another video, and today we are doing another bass design video. The last video got mixed reviews on it. Some of you guys liked it, some of you guys didn't like it. To be completely honest with you guys, I didn't put much thought into that last video. So this video, me and my friend Gavin, we have been sitting here for probably about an hour working on this design, perfecting it, making it a lot better. So hopefully you guys do enjoy this video and hit that like button. All right guys, let's get into the tour. So you go through 5 sheet metal doors or armor doors. It's just whatever you like. Okay, so you get to this one by one where your TC will be placed, stuff will go in there, a campfire, maybe a box, a few furnaces, whatever you would like. So then you go up this ladder hatch, and this is the loot room floor. All of these are loot rooms, except for that corner over there. That's where your airlocks are. So shut the ladder hatch, and you go down into your first loot room. This door is armored, but it really doesn't have to be. It's just what we put down. When you're making this loot room, you want to upgrade this floor to armored and the chute right here to sheet metal. As you guys just saw, if they blow through this door, there's a shotgun trap waiting for them. So if you go down the chute, you'll see the top. There's a top 3 boxes in here. You can access all of them. See, there's the back one. There's this, it's a little bit annoying to get to, but there's that front one, and there's this, it's hard to get to, there we go, there's the back one. Now we're here. This is like the most unraidable loot room right here, because as you guys can see, it's 3 shotgun traps, 3 boxes. So if they drop down in the chute, they're immediately getting blasted, and they can't do anything about it. Oh, and by the way, here's my friend Gavin. He's got his mic muted, so he's not going to talk, but yeah, there's my friend Gavin. Thanks for the help, by the way, and yeah. So in the rest of these, it will be the exact same thing. Let's get up to the roof. You go up another ladder hatch, which can be stairs if you would like, or ladders, you never know. You go through one door here. This is the roof access. This is where you will do all your raid defending, your PvPing, and I guess your roof camping. A double door with a stone barricade. You can look out on raiders, PvPers, and enemies. You also got just a regular door here. If you need to jump out, you need to do anything, you know, crouch and look around, you know, whatever. Here's another regular door, obviously, and look down. Now, here's my favorite part of the roof. You open both of these doors. And now you can peek from this corner and look at people over here. You can stand up and look. And you can look through this little triangle shape. And you can also look through this double door. If you go to the other side, it's the exact same thing before. A double door and one lookout door. And here's another lookout door. And it's the same thing as over there. A double door with a stone barricade. Another double door, which you can just look around and look through the crack. This is what your base should look like when it's done. Alright, so let's get to the building of the base. This is what the base will cost. Obviously, the high qual and the metal frags is optional because that's the chute upgrade and that's the loot room upgrade, so you guys don't have to do that. So this is how the start of the base will go. You will need to place a square foundation a little bit off the ground. Place a triangle on every side. Now on these two ends, place 2 squares. On the other end, place 2 squares. Place a triangle on the end, place a triangle on the end, and place a triangle on the end, and place a triangle on the end. Now just fill it in. Now once you've filled it in, upgrade it all to stone. So now is when you want to place your TC. Make a doorway and make 3 walls to house your TC, and make a floor frame. Upgrade all of this to stone. So now is when you want to place your TC down. When you got your TC down, obviously put wood, metal frags, stone in there. Now place down your ladder hatch. Once you've got that, put a door on the front, and boom, now you got your TC room. Now is when you start building the actual outside of the base. You want to choose one of these 4 triangles to build your outer doorway on. I'm going to choose this one. Got a doorway here, doorway here, a doorway here, a doorway here. Now place walls all the way around the outside of the base. Upgraded it all to stone. So now you want to honeycomb these parts on the base. once you've done that, now you want to save these squares and these triangles and not honeycomb them, because that's where your loot's going to go. So you want to go around here and block off the parts that's not your loot room. So here, 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 rotate, here, 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 and here, 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 and here. So now you've got the first floor done. So now you want to place a roof on this first layer. When it comes to the loot rooms, you want to place a square on this, but leave the triangles open. On the door side, you can cover up that triangle. So now you want to place a wall all the way around the outside of the base. When you get to the loot rooms, you want to place a half wall on one side and a big wall on the other. The reason why you want to place a half wall is so you can place a triangle and another half wall and another triangle. Up here will be your shotgun trap or your auto turret. Now do this on all sides. So now make the same TC room right here again. But this time nothing will be going in it. You'll just place another floor frame and put another ladder hatch right up there. You've got that done. Make sure there's a door on this. And now it's your time to do the loot rooms. So before you do anything, place a wall frame in all separate loot rooms. And now you want to either place your auto turret or your shotgun turret up there. You can hang this from the ceiling, or you can just place it up there. Now you got the shotgun trap placed, so you need to either place a sheet metal double door or an armored double door. It's whatever materials you have. No matter which way it goes. It can go in or out, it's just whatever your preference is. I'm going to do in. So you open up this door, you want to go down here. Here, place a half wall and then a floor. Destroy that half wall, and now is when you place your boxes. So get three boxes, place one far left as far back as you can, place one far right as far back as you can, and now what you want to do is you really want to push this box as far back as you can, because you'll have to place a low wall. See, I did it wrong here, but I'll do it again. One more box and place it right here in the middle, place it as close as you can to those boxes. Now is when you place your three shotgun traps down. This is a very tedious process, you have to do it perfect. But you want to place it as close to the box as you can and pointing a little bit upward. Place it on the other side the exact same way. And if you can, place one directly in the middle here. And see if you can access all the turrets and boxes with this half wall, with this low wall being here. You can upgrade them to sheet metal or armored. I highly recommend armored if you can. Same thing with these walls here. Upgrade them to armored. And upgrade that to armor. Now, upgrade everything around you here to sheet metal. I highly recommend this. So now on this top part, you're going to do the exact same thing, except for without the shotgun traps. So you want to place three boxes up here. Boom. Boom. And this is going to be a hard box to place. But if you can, you need to make sure you get this place right. You want to make sure you place this box as close to the middle as you can. Otherwise, you won't be able to access those back two boxes. Once you made sure you're able to access these back two boxes, you can upgrade this part. So the only way possible for you to get out of this situation is a ladder. It's a little bit hard to get out. It's a little bit tedious to get out, but eventually you'll be able to do it. If you're not going to place an auto turret, you can just remove this floor. There you go. There's your loot room. Now do that on all other sides. So this second floor can be where your research stuff goes. Like maybe you honeycomb this part over here on both sides. Make door access to your loot rooms. Now this side over here, the one side that doesn't have loot rooms, you can make research bench, workbench, and repair bench. So place doors going to it. And there you go. Here's this other part. You want to probably wall that off. Place another door here. And place doors all the way around till you get to the other loot room. Boom, wall that off, and here's your other loot room. So once you've placed doors all the way around on this, you can start the roof. So now Gavin's going to help me on this part because obviously he knows how to do it. So Gavin built this. This is basically what you want to build. You go to this side, you build a square and a triangle, place a door, a wall, a double door frame, a doorway, a wall, a doorway, a square, triangle, wall, doorway, a double doorway, doorway, wall, a doorway, and there you go. That's your top part. So now upgrade all of this to stone. So now you want to go to the square and the triangle. You want a wall here, a double door frame here. Leave this spot open right here. And see beside the square where the other double door is, you want to place another double door on the right side of this triangle. Now get a concrete barricade and you want to place it as close to the door frame as you can, but without getting in the way of the door being placed. So as you can see, if it's blue, you weren't too close. So you want to place it facing inward. Boom. Now they've updated the building where it's a lot harder to do this, but place a concrete barricade where it's a crack right here. Now Gavin's going to replicate it on the other side. Here, Gavin, place one really close to this without getting in the way of the door. Boom. So Gavin did it, and you make it face inward again. Gavin made this one a little bit smaller, but it will work. So now what you want to do is you want to go around on all of these single doors and place sheet metal doors on them. Alright, help me, Gavin. Make them all go outward. Did I do them all? Two. So now that I've got all single doors placed, Gavin has placed the concrete barricades in every other double doorway. So all you gotta do is just place the sheet metal double door in that spot. Once that is placed, you wanna place the roof on this base. This is going to be the best of fitting for your base. There's so many angles that you can hit raiders and they will definitely not expect this. Now, like I said on the other parts, make a doorway here and make three walls. Place a doorway on it. And there you go. Now, do whatever you want up here. You definitely want to airlock it. Not much where it's cluttery and you can't defend that well, but airlock it so if they ladder up, they can't just blow straight into your loot. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. This is a base design video. Obviously the last one had mixed results. Hopefully this one is more one-sided than the last one because it has all three parts. Easy access loot room for the builder and an easy access roof where you can defend against the raiders. If you guys have enjoyed, like I said, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Go check out Gavin on Steam and Discord. I'll put that on the screen now and in the description. I'll catch you guys in my next video. Peace.
Peace.
Thank you guys for watching all the way to the end of the video. I greatly appreciate it. If you want to see more content by me, look up in the top left. There's my previous upload. Look up in the top right. There's a random upload. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I greatly appreciate it. Check out my Twitter, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Peace.